to my channel. It's Ashanti and Nola. Say hey, Nola. So I was getting ready to finish editing a video. Nola was kind of lounging. Now she's trying to be in video too. But this video is actually old. Well, not too incredibly old. I filmed it on my birthday, May 15th. And then everything in the world started happening. Just a lot in the black community. So I did not feel right uploading this video at the time. Just trying to focus on what's really important, what really matters. And I just wasn't in the mood. I just was not in the mood to upload any content. I filmed this video on my birthday, and it was actually me and my husband going to pick up our dog. And I hope this provides some lighthearted content for everyone during this time. And I'm gonna also link some resources down at the bottom in the description box, as well as some ways that you can help out during this time, signing some petitions, donating to a cause, just trying to, it's just crazy how much is going on and what keeps happening to my black people. And I just don't want to continue to live in a world that is so against us. Like, we have to do something about it. We have to make a change. We have to use our voices. We have to vote to actually make things happen. And yeah, it's not gonna change if we don't do the work. So I hope you guys enjoy this video, and I just wanted to add this little commentary in there just kind of preface what's going on and why it's such a late upload. But I'm trying to get back to being a little bit more consistent. I have another video I need to get back to editing that's late as well. But I just hope you guys enjoy this video, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to also check out those resources that are going to be linked in the description box. Thanks. Today is super exciting because not only is it my birthday, we're getting a golden doodle puppy, and I can't wait. We're excited. We have to go drive to the breeder and pick her up. So we're getting ready to leave, just packing up our water, juices, snacks, and things like that for on the road. Earlier you saw me getting ready, and I was uploading some new arrivals to my website, so be sure to go check that out at lovelyenoughxo.com. I'll leave the link in the description box so y'all can go check that out. And yeah, so we're super excited, just getting everything together for her. It is a girl. Her name is going to be Nola, or her name is Nola. The breeder has been calling her by her name, so she should recognize it when we pick her up and start calling her. But yeah, I got my bag packed. I'll show y'all what we got going on. So we got some fruit, and here's our little cooler that's going in the car. Got some waters, apple juice, orange juice, some grapes. And we got some other little snacks we're bringing. We've packed up some of these Velveeta breakfast cookies. And I have a bag right here that all her stuff is going to go in. So what happened with this? This is some last minute stuff we got because everything we ordered off Amazon, but it wasn't going to be here until today since we're leaving and then coming on Sunday as well. So we got some towels for her, puppy pads for in the car, and some little chew toys and stuff like that. So
we're gonna be all good to go.
So we got the car all loaded up. Look at our little puppy car seat back there. And then we got our cooler, some snacks, and Nola's stuff. It's back there as well. About to pull out the driveway and be on our way. It's about a 4 hour and 30 minute drive. So we should be there around 1 o'clock to get her, and then we're gonna stop to get something to eat for lunch and be on our way back. So yeah, and the weather is not bad. It was raining pretty much all day yesterday, like from the afternoon until the evening time. So now, I mean, it's kind of cloudy. I think it said it's gonna rain, but hopefully we don't run into a lot of rain on the road and stuff like that. That is smooth and, you know, not bad driving at all, because when it rains, people don't know how to drive. We officially made it into Texas. We just crossed the state line, so we are headed there. We are exactly 1 hour away now, so we should be arriving there by 1:43 to get the puppy. Trying to figure out what we're going to eat afterwards. It's not that many places around here. This is like a lot of rural area, very country town, kind of like. They had a McDonald's and a Burger King. I think that's all I saw. There was a crawfish place, but we can't bring the dog in, so we'll have to figure out something what we're going to eat. But just a little update. What you came for, lightning. We are almost there. The GPS says we have exactly 9 minutes left to go. Yay! Baby, this is what you came for. Lightning strikes every time she moves. Everybody's watching her, but she's looking at you. Ooh, ooh, you. So we are officially on our way back. We got our puppy. Jamal is holding her now. Her name is Nola. I had her in my lap and we were going to try to sit on the floor. She threw up twice because of the car ride. But she's doing okay now. She looks like she might take a nap. And she's so soft, and we talked to the breeder for a good bit while we were there, and she was very helpful. She's been helpful throughout the whole process. So if you guys are looking for a golden doodle of your own, I definitely recommend Vintage Doodles, based out of Texas. You can look her up on Instagram, and she also has a Facebook page too, but we'll put all that information in the description box so you can check her out. Happy Saturday! So I did not end the vlog from yesterday, but we do officially have little Miss Nola here. She is living her puppy best life. We are trying to crate train her. Been watching YouTube videos on how to successfully crate train and potty train. Her first night wasn't that bad. She did have a couple accidents. She peed on the carpet. but sprayed some pet cleaner on that to take care of that. Yeah, she did. When she came home, she used the potty, like the puppy pads. She used it successfully one time. She used it another time inside her crate, but then we found out that it's not good to put the puppy pad inside the crate, so we took it out. And she used it again, but she missed the target. Like, she peed on the edge of the puppy pad and not directly onto the puppy pad, so I had to clean that up. And she did have an accident in her little puppy bed that we got her, so I washed that. But other than that, she's pretty mild-mannered. Just trying to get her used to the crate and training her with the little treats and tone of voice commands. But other than that, she's so good. She's just chilling right there. I'm trying to get her used to wearing her little harness. It's a little bit big for her. And also wearing the leash. We just kind of like walked her around inside the house, just kind of desensitizing her to that. And yeah, other than that, the drive home was long. She did okay. She threw up 3 times with car sickness, but it wasn't nothing major. I had the puppy pad and had her sitting in my lap on top of the puppy pad, so that was easy cleanup and things like that. But she was dead tired when she made it here to our house. So yeah, just trying to get her used to things. And there's a few other things that we're waiting on from Amazon that should be here between today and tomorrow. And I do actually need to go to Walmart and get an attachment pin to go around her kennel. That way she can have some free range play area, especially while me and Jamal go back to work this week. So, yeah, that's how that's going. But other than that, I hope you guys continue to stay tuned. Look at her. Let me take care of this. Looking forward to the long journey ahead, but I think she's gonna do well. She's learning. She's trying to catch on pretty quickly. But of course, it doesn't happen overnight, especially with a puppy. And she's 8 weeks old at that, so she has plenty of time to pick up on things, and I think she's gonna do well. But I hope you guys continue to stay tuned for more videos for me. Please be sure to like this video, comment down below what else you want to see and what you think of little Miss Nola, and if you want to see more videos with her. And also subscribe to my channel for more content like this. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time. So I didn't think I would be coming back to the video, but we finally got our Amazon package back. Let me flip the camera this way. Okay. We finally got our Amazon package back. They delivered it today. I think we have maybe a couple more things coming. I'm gonna double check. But this is what we got for Nola so far. We have her little potty training bells attached to the door. So right now she's still using the puppy pads. Let me flip this one. So right now she's still using the puppy pads, but when she gets old enough, we are going to be training her on how to ring the bell so she can go out the door and let us know that she needs to go potty. What else did we get? This is the shampoo and conditioner that we ordered. It had some pretty good ratings. It says naturally deodorizing, relieving dry, itchy skin. So it has organic aloe vera and baking soda in it, and it's oatmeal. We have her shampoo brush. We also have another brush in here too. Oh, this one right here, which is the slicker brush. It's a small one. Her breeder actually gave us one for her. She gave us a little goodie bag, which was really sweet, that came with a larger slicker brush. And the breeder's mom made some really cute little bandanas for her, so we have those and just some information in there. And what else did we get? I ordered her some toys, and it was like a set of three toys. So there's like a little rope that she can chew on, a little teething ring with the rope attachment, and then a teething bone. And they came with this little travel bag in there. Oh, and also came with another ball. So this is like her third ball that she has. We also got her the little disposable poop bags and the refill. Well, actually, this one came in the set with the toys. I think this was like a free gift. But the matching poop bag refills are right here. Are made with recycled materials. I want to say, are they biodegradable? It doesn't say. I can't remember if I got these because they were biodegradable or not, but they are 100% leak-proof. We also got her some bully sticks, so she can chew on these to occupy her time, especially while we're gone during the day. And I also got her a travel food and water bowl. I can show you guys this really quick. It's by Dog Buddy. So what you do is you can unzip it. So when you unzip it, it looks like this, and you can just pop it up and put food and water in there, and it's collapsible, which is really cool. So you can also do it like this, so it's not a full size bowl, or you can bring it all the way up. This is really cool. I'm just excited to use this. I wanted to take this with us when we went to go get her, but it didn't come in time, of course. But yeah, she was fine though.
No.
On her ride
out the kitchen.
Back home. Out the kitchen. So that's that box. And then we also got her retractable leash. Pink and black retractable leash. And this is her matching harness. This is her little harness, a pink and black one. I think, I can't remember what size this is. I think it was an extra small. It looks like it would fit her better than the one we have for her currently, which I think is like a size maybe smaller. But yeah, so that's for that. And then these are her training pads. We ordered these, but we bought some from I had bought some from Big Lots just because we needed some. But this is by Glad, and they're the activated carbon training pads. They hold up to 3 cups of liquid. So yeah, I think these would be good for her. I'm actually kind of wanting to try some of these as opposed to the ones that we have her using right now. But that's that. And oh, the other thing that I'm really excited that we got for her, and she's using it right now, but it's her slow feeding food and water bowl. So it looks like that. So the food is basically, she can only do three-fourths of a cup right now anyway, so she doesn't have to have that much in her food portion. But it's meant so she doesn't choke on her food. And then her water, like as she taps it, it releases the water. It's like a floating disc on the top, so she can drink her water. But what I like about it is it's big enough where she can't tip it over, but she did dip her paw in there. So that'll probably be the only mess that we have to clean up, but it won't be her whole bowl flipping over, which is the issue that we've been having so far. But I'm really excited about that for her. I think she'll really like that. And she seems to be using it pretty fine. Oh, look, Nola, you got you a gourmet meal. I think she's gonna eat that up. So my husband basically did some chicken for her, just unseasoned baked chicken. Oh, we do have this playpen for her right now. We did have her crate attached to it, but we decided to put her crate in our room just so she can sleep in there. And then this will be where she goes during the day, like while we're gone at work. Yeah, nothing else in here. I think I'm gonna just go ahead and sanitize her toys, and that way she can play with these. And I'll probably see if her harness fits on her. But yeah, that was pretty much it. I didn't know I was going to be returning to the video, so I'll go ahead and end the video again here. Thank you guys so much for watching. And if you like this content, again, just let me know and I can put more videos in here showing Nola and just, you know, how we're adjusting to her and how she's adjusting to us and things like that. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.